Brahmacharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the pastimes of Gop Kumara, a cowherd boy from Govardhan, who traveled into the spiritual world.
我们讲述的是Gopakumar的故事，他是高人山的一个牧牛童，然后他就旅行到了灵性世界。
So he went to Vaikuntha, and from Vaikuntha he went to Dwarka, and in Dwarka he met with Narada Muni and Uddhava.
然后之后呢，又就去了多尔卡，在多尔卡他遇见Narada Muni，也遇见了Uddhava。So
in the association of Narada Muni and Uddhava, Narada Muni was telling Gop Kumar about the nature of Gokula.
在Narada Muni和Uddhava的陪伴下呢，Narada Muni就给Gopakumar讲了Gokula的本性。Right,
there's two places. There's Goloka and Gokula. Goloka is the spiritual world, and Gokula is here in this world.
有两个世界，Goloka和Gokula。Goloka是在灵性世界。
And in both places, the Lord performs his pastimes. But there's a difference. The difference is that in Goloka, the Lord is always present, and in Gokula, he's sometimes present.
这两个世界呢，这两个地方有精微的区别。在Goloka，主总是在那里；而在Gokula呢，主有的时候在。So
Narada Muni was telling Gop Kumar about the wonderful pastimes Lord Krishna performs in Gokula.
Narada Muni 就给Gopakumar讲述了主 Krishna 在Gokula 他的美妙的笑时光。
And he was describing, he'd come to the point of describing Lord Krishna's Rasa Leela. And he was describing how Lord Krishna played tricks with the gopis, which made them cry. They said that Lord Krishna was dealing with them in a manner which was not fair.
主对待牧牛姑娘的方式呢，就是对他们是不公平的。
Because Lord Krishna would tease, he would tease them. He would call them, he would go to the forest and play on the flute and call the gopis to come. And when they came, then he would say, why are you coming here?
主就逗弄他们，逗他们玩，就说，因为主 Krishna 呢，在森林里，他吹响自己的笛子，然后召唤了牧牛姑娘来了之后呢，他反而又问他们，你们到这里来干什么来了？为什么来这里？
So, Lord Krishna then would explain to them the actual nature of his dealing with them. The Lord Krishna is very expert in not revealing his mind to the gopis. But when they began to cry, then he showed them his actual true feelings. And that increased the gopis' love for Krishna. It's innate. When we worship Krishna with a pure heart, then the nature of that worship is that we will awaken love for Krishna. And that's why Krishna came into this material world, to attract all of us to develop love for him. But his pastimes appear like the activities of an ordinary person. But at the same time, while he's performing these activities, that he shows his opulence, he shows his feature as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna is always smiling at the devotees, and when he's smiling at them, then the gopis become more lusty to enjoy with Krishna.
Krishna 会向他的奉献者微笑，每当这时候呢。
So this is transcendental sense enjoyment. This is not material. So the gopis are able to enjoy the company of Krishna. But sometimes also Krishna will break their hearts. This is all the pastimes of the Lord. Sometimes he appears, he's with the gopis, and then sometimes he will disappear. When he calls them all to dance Rasa Leela, and he'll be dancing with them, and each gopi will become proud, thinking Krishna's dancing with me, and then Krishna will disappear.
Oh, Krishna, Krishna只跟我一个人跳舞，这时候他们就会感到骄傲。
And these gopis were from very good families. They were very, you know, they were not low-class people. They were very cultured and sophisticated ladies. Of course, they were young. They're not very old ladies. They're younger. Krishna's a young boy when he's dancing with them.
这些牧牛姑娘呢，她们都是青春年少的，而 Krishna 呢，也是一个风华正茂的青年。
And when, but when Krishna would leave them, then the gopis, they would become, they would show the most unusual ways of, they would, you know, of speaking. Their behavior and acting and separation from Krishna was very, very special.
Krishna 离开这个现场的时候呢，勾皮们他们的行为举止呢就非同寻常，他们的言谈举止，他们的说话方式都是展现出一种特别的情绪。
You know, when they would be looking for Krishna, they would talk to the trees and they would talk to the just different animals in the forest. That did you see Krishna? Oh, you must have seen. You know they.They'd see it, some special sign in the animal or in the tree, which indicated Krishna had gone that way.
他们会当 Krishna 离开的时候呢，牧牛姑娘会跟这个森林里的树木和动物说话。你们见到 Krishna 了吗？他们会寻找 Krishna 的踪影。然后他们会寻找有些特殊的一些迹象，从动物啊树木的树木的身上寻找 Krishna 他离开的方向。
So Krishna is very expert in making his devotees feel this pain and separation from him.
Krishna 是特别擅长让奉献者感受到跟他的分离之苦。
And so it happened more than one time. It wasn't just once. There were seven different occasions when Krishna would disappear.
这个事情呢发生了不止一次，在好几次呢不同的情况下呢 ，Krishna 都从牧牛姑娘的眼前消失了。
And they would talk to the trees, and they would talk to the plants, and they'd tell the trees that.That son of Nanda Maharaj, he's stolen our mind with him. He's taken away our minds by his smiling and by his glancing. He's stolen our hearts.
牧牛姑娘们就开始向这些树木和植物说话。Nanda Maharaj 的那个儿郎，他偷走了我们的心，他用他的微笑。他用他的瞥视把我们的心意都偷跑了。
Then the gopis would begin to remember Krishna's pastimes and they would start to act. They would begin to re-perform the pastimes which Krishna had done.
勾皮们就开始模仿 Krishna 的他的那些逍遥时光。
So this is the highest level of devotional service, which is known only by people like Srimati Radharani and her gopi friends.
这就是奉献服务的最高的层面，这只是由那些牧牛姑娘 Radharani 和她的牧牛姑娘朋友们，他们所处的层面。
So Narada Muni says,These pastimes are so inconceivable, he said, I become frightened when I hear them.
Narada Muni 说这些逍遥时光是太不可思议了，每当我想起的时候呢，我都感到害怕。
That in one moment he will give the gopis the greatest pleasure by being with him and by embracing them, and the next moment he will disappear from them.
在这一时刻呢，主 Krishna 还在拥抱着牧牛姑娘，跟他们在一起，给他们带来最大的快乐。而下一时刻呢，他又突然间消失了。
So he can only offer, Narada Muni can only offer his respects to Lord Krishna.
Narada Muni 他只能向主 Krishna 致以他的敬意。
Of course, one time even Krishna had taken Radharani away from all the gopis and he was just alone with Radharani. But then he disappeared from Radharani also.
有一时刻呢，主 Krishna 呢就把 Radharani 从所有牧牛姑娘面前就单独带走了，但是呢，他又从 Radharani 面前也消失了。
And of course, the gopis and Radharani, they're all crying in separation from Krishna. And so that crying, they're crying for Krishna, that brought Krishna back. He reappeared to them and brought them the greatest happiness.
牧牛姑娘和 Radharani 的眼泪泪水就把主 Krishna 又带到了他们身边。然后当 Krishna 回到他们面前的时候，他们又感到巨大的快乐。
So when Krishna appeared again, then the gopis asked him about this attitude, his strange attitude, his unusual dealings with them.
当 Krishna 重新出现在他们面前的时候，牧牛姑娘就向 Krishna 询问。他跟他们之间这种非同寻常的这个行为举止。
Gopis said to Krishna, the gopis said that, you know, there's some people, they show affection only to those who are affectionate to them. But there are others, they show affection to those who are not even nice to them.
Gopis 们就对 Krishna 说，有些人呢，只会去爱那些，向他们表示爱意的人，而有另外一些人呢，即使别人对他们不好，他们也会爱对方。
But there are others who show affection towards any, they won't show affection to anyone.
还有另外一些人呢，谁都不爱。
So the gopis ask Krishna, "Can you explain this to us?"
Gopi 就向 Krishna 询问，您能不能向我们解释这些呢？
You know, because the gopis, they're actually talking about Krishna, that he, Krishna, you're like this, you know. We cannot understand you. Sometimes you're affectionate, sometimes you're not.
实际上牧牛姑娘就在暗示的是 Krishna 本人。我们不能理解你，有的时候呢，你对我们满怀爱意，但有的时候呢，你又不爱我们。
So Krishna told the gopis in reply, he said, "I'm not able to repay my debt to you for your service."
Krishna 这样对牧牛姑娘回答道：“我无法偿还你们为我所做的服务。”
He said, "Even in a lifetime of Brahma, I cannot repay my debt to you."
即便是以 Brahma 一生的那样的长度，我也无法偿还我欠你们的债。
Your relationship with me is perfect. There's no fault anywhere in your dealings.
你们和我之间的关系是完美无瑕的。其中在我们的交往当中没有任何的瑕疵缺陷。
You broke off all your relationships with your families, although it's very difficult to do that, just to worship me. You gave up your family relationships.
你们斩断了和家庭成员的所有联系，只是为了和我待在一起。你们为了崇拜我。你们就切断了所有跟亲朋好友的这种关系。
So how can I? How he said I cannot repay you for what you've done for me. He said I cannot give up my family, but you gave up your family.
Krishna 说，为此我是永远无法偿报答你们的。你们可以切断跟亲友的关系。而我却不能切断和家庭的关系。
So, and how can I compensate you? You will have to just be satisfied by your own activities.
我如何才能补偿你们呢？请你们只是为了对自己的行为感到满意，心满意足就好了。
So this was Krishna's reply. to the gopis.
这是 Krishna 对牧牛姑娘们的回答。
Very famous, Krishna saying, I cannot repay you. Although Krishna is Bhagavan and he has all wealth, but he said, I have no wealth to repay the gopis.
这是非常著名的一段对话。Krishna 对牧牛姑娘的答案非常有著名。虽然他本人是 Bhagavan, 他拥有一切的财富，但是他却说他无法来回报牧牛姑娘。
So Krishna was, how was it Krishna was able to attract the gopis so much? He was so clever, he was so expert in, first he could do things like arrange the gopis, put the gopis in a circle, and then dance and sing with them.
Krishna 和牧牛姑娘，他对待牧牛姑娘是非常精到的，非常的聪明的，他把牧牛姑娘们安排他们围成一圈，跟自己在那里跳 Rasa 之舞。
So Narada Muni said these pastimes of Krishna they were never seen before, and they just steal away the heart of everyone.
Narada Muni 说这种逍遥时光呢是前所未有的，没有人曾经见过这一逍遥时光。
Krishna even had pastimes in the water with they would go in the Yamuna and play and splash each other with water.
Krishna 呢还跟牧牛姑娘一起进入亚穆那河水当中，彼此就向对方泼溅那个河水。
So people who enjoy hearing about Krishna, they know how special those devotees are.Who take pleasure in hearing about Krishna.
非常喜欢聆听 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘之间的逍遥时光的奉献者们，知道他们之间的这个交往是多么独特，他们之间的交往的超人的本性。
Even Lord Brahma, he has a very strong desire to get in the mercy of these devotees of Gokula.
即便是主 Brahma 本人也渴望得到 Gokula 这些奉献者的仁慈。
And Uddhava also, he wants to get he knows about the greatness, the special significance, the purity of the gopis.
Uddhava 也知道勾辟他们的伟大和他们的纯粹。
So Narada has been telling us about how wonderful the people of Vrindavan are. Now he wants to tell us more detail about these devotees.
Narada 就讲述了 Vrindavan 的这些居民他们的独特之处，接着呢他会描述细节。
So both Brahma and Uddhava, they understood how fortunate the people of Vrindavan are.
Brahma 和 Uddhava 都知道 Vrindavan 的居民他们是多么的何其幸运。
Like after Brahma had stolen the cows and the boys from Krishna, and Krishna had defeated Brahma, then Brahma offered his prayers to Lord Krishna.
When Brahma 从 Krishna 那里偷走了所有的牛犊还有所有的牧牛童的时候，后来他被 Krishna 打败了。
And he in his prayers, he told Krishna, he said,I don't just want to become, I want to become your servant, but specifically, I want to get the mercy of the people of Vrindavan. I want to get a little mercy from these people of Vrindavan.
Brahma 对 Krishna 说，我渴望成为您的仆人，但是我尤其渴望能获得 Vrindavan 居民的特殊仁慈。
He said, if somehow if I can get a birth in the forest of Gokul, then I can get the dust from the feet of the people there.
如果我能想方设法的在狗窟的再次投生，我就能得到那里的人们他们足下的尘土了。
And Uddhava, he'd gone to Vrindavan. Krishna had sent Uddhava to Vrindavan with a message for the gopis. So he had seen the gopis and he knew about the position of the gopis.
Uddhava 曾经被 Krishna 派到 Vrindavan 去烧给牧牛姑娘烧信，所以他知道他在那里见过牧牛姑娘，他知道这些他问他们居民的本性。
Now Uddhava, he was already a servant of Krishna. So he doesn't just pray to be a servant of Krishna because he's already a servant of Krishna.
Uddhava 是 Krishna 的仆人，所以呢，他并不祈祷能成为 Krishna 仆人。
Brahma was just, he's just a ruler of the material world. So he was happy, he's asking to become a pure servant of Krishna.
Brahma 呢，他是物质世界的统治者，所以他很高兴能够祈祷成为主 Krishna 纯粹的仆人。
But Uddhava, he's already Krishna's servant and friend. So he's not going to ask for that. He wants something more, right? And he wants that I could be fortunate enough to become one of the bushes or herbs which grow in Vrindavan.
但是 Uddhava 本人他就是 Krishna 的仆人和朋友，所以他并没有祈求要求成为 Krishna 的仆人，他想要得到更多，所以他就祈求他能有幸在 Vrindavan 投生为一丛草，甚至是一个植物。
Yeah, because Uddhava knows the gopis will walk there, and that way he can get the dust from their feet.
因为 Uddhava 知道牧牛姑娘呢，他们会经过 Vrindavan 的路，然后他就能以此方式得到他们足下的尘土了。
He knows the gopis would never agree to give them the dust from their feet.So he wants to take birth in that way he can get the dust. The gopis themselves, they speak about the good fortune of Krishna's flute.Because they know Krishna's flute has got something which they're not able to get. Krishna's flute is always tasting the nectar of Krishna's lips.
因为 Krishna 的这根笛子，它总在那里品尝着 Krishna 唇上的甘露。
The gopis there also, they have that desire. They envy that flute because the flute's always, Krishna's always playing the flute. So the flute is always tasting the nectar of Krishna's lips. The gopis would like to be in that position.
Gopi 们都有这种向往。因为他们就开始嫉妒这根笛子，因为 Krishna 总在吹奏着这根笛子，他总在品尝着 Krishna 唇上的甘醇，所以牧牛姑娘也希望处在那样的地位。
Now, the gopis say we only get a taste of that nectar, but that flute is tasting the nectar of Krishna's lips constantly, continually.
狗皮们说，我们只是。对 Krishna 唇上的甘露有我们只是偶尔品尝到这个甘露，可是这根笛子却恒常不断地品尝着它唇上的甘露。
But that nectar is really meant for us, but that flute isn't taking all the nectar all the time. It's meant for us. We're meant to get that nectar.
这个Krishna 纯粹的甘露是本来是给我们的，可是这根笛子却把这所有的甘露都抢走了。本来这些甘露呢，都是应该由我们来品尝的。
And the gopis speak about, they say that the forefathers of the flute are the bamboo trees, and they're shedding tears of pleasure. They're so happy that their offspring, their descendant, the flute, is tasting Krishna's lips.
Gopi 们说，这根竹子的祖先，他就是他的祖先，那根竹子，他一定是在喜乐当中流着泪水，因为他的后代可以这样品尝到 Krishna 唇上的甘露。
And the, who's the mother of the bamboo flute? The mother of the bamboo flute is the river on whose bank the bamboo was born.
而这个竹子的母亲又是谁呢？他的母亲就是这个竹子生长着的那条河的，这个竹子生长着的。他在这个河岸旁边生长的是这根河流。
And because the river is feeling jubilation, she's so happy about this, about her son, who is tasting Krishna's nectar. That because the river is so happy and so proud, the lotus flowers, which grow out from the river, they're standing like hair on her body.
有这种地位感到快乐，所以呢，在他的河上的这个莲花就盛开了。
This is another ecstasy, hair standing on end, right? So the lotus flowers are standing on end in the river because of pride that their flute is in Krishna's mouth.
所以，毛发指数是狂喜的一个征兆。因此，这个河上的这个莲花盛开，就好像是，毛发指数一样。他们一定会为这根竹子也感到骄傲。
Then Narada Muni describes. He says, Krishna is so attached to his friends, to his devotees, to these companions of his, that he doesn't even notice Brahma, who's offering prayers and bowing to him.
接着说 ，Krishna 是对他的朋友、对他同伴是如此的依恋，他甚至没有意识到，主 Krishna 正在主 Brahma 呢 ，Brahma 正在向他顶礼，献上祈祷。
Brahma is his oldest son.
Brahma 是他的大儿子。
So even great demigods and great sages come to visit Krishna.Krishna is more attached to his friends and family in Vrindavan.
甚至那些半神人、圣人们都会来拜访 Krishna， 但是 Krishna 是这么钟爱他的 Vrindavan 的朋友、家人。
Yeah, after Brahma had stolen the cows, and then he offered prayers to Krishna and apologizing.Krishna didn't, he wasn't even interested. He didn't look at him.
Brahma, 他偷走了 Krishna 的母牛之后呢，他就向 Krishna 感到表示道歉。但是 Krishna, 他对 Brahma 不感兴趣，甚至看也不看他一眼。
He didn't even speak to him. He didn't speak a word. He just did that, you know, just went away, left him in disgust.More interesting, Krishna is so attached to his family and friends in Vrindavan.
So, when Krishna, when Brahma 过来向 Krishna 表示歉意的时候呢 ，Krishna 呢是一句话也没有说，就是厌恶的就跑掉了，因为他这么依附 Vrindavan 的家人，依附他的朋友。
And Indra, he tried to destroy Vrindavan and all the people in Vrindavan. So Indra, when he came to apologize, he came along with Surabhi. So Indra was offering prayers. At that time, Krishna spoke to him. Indra was worried that he may be kicked out, he may lose his position. So Krishna paid some attention to Indra because he wanted him to know that he was pleased with the position which Indra had given him. Krishna was pleased because at this time he was given two new names. He was made the Lord of the Cows. He was given the name Govinda, meaning the Lord of the Cows, and he was given another name Upendra. And he was pleased also because Surabhi was there. She had come with Indra, and Surabhi is the ancestor of all cows. And because Surabhi requested Krishna to forgive Indra for his offenses, so Krishna became kind to Indra. But Narada Muni says, he said, Krishna won't even speak to me even for a moment. He said, my only goal in life is his lotus feet, but Krishna doesn't talk to me. Krishna is only attracted to be with these people from the forest, the cowherd people. He doesn't like me. Narada is just a simple devotee. He's a simple devotee. He's not like a demigod. He doesn't have any material position. But Krishna is so active with the Brijbasis that he hasn't got time to speak to Narada Muni. Narada Muni thinks maybe these Brijbasi people, they give some drug to Krishna to control his mind.
Narada Muni 想, 也许这些 Brijbasi 就给 Krishna, 吸食了一些毒品, 就控制到他的心意。
Of course, Krishna cannot be controlled by any drug. Krishna's always spiritual, transcendental body. Even if you give drug, it won't affect Krishna.
Krishna, 没有哪些药物, 麻醉药物能控制 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 他拥有是灵性的超然的身体，甚至那些药物也对他不起作用。
The only thing which can control Krishna is the pure love of his devotees. And the Brijbasi people, they have that pure love.
唯一能控制 Krishna 的是他的纯粹奉献者的纯洁无瑕的爱，而 Brijbasi 是拥有这份爱的。
So these, Narada Muni appreciates how these Brijbasi people are so cleverthat they have Krishna under their control.
Narada Muni 呢就赞扬这些 Brijbasi， 他们太聪明了，他们甚至控制了 Krishna.
But Narada Muni knows that these Brijbasi people have the greatest attachment to Krishna.
但是 Narada Muni 深知这些 Brijbasi 对 Krishna 怀着深深的依恋。
And they know Krishna, they don't think of him as God, they just think of him as the son of Nanda Maharaj, as a cowherd boy. And although they have this love, they have this deep love for Krishna,They're always in distress. So, the nature of their love for Krishna is that it appears to be distress, it appears to be unhappiness.
他们对 Krishna 的这份爱的本性，就好像他们总是在痛苦当中，他们总是闷闷不乐。
These Brijbasi people are so special that even the Yadavas, the Krishna's family, the Yadus, they know about the ecstasy of Vaikuntha, but they worship the people of Vrindavan.
These Brijbasi, they are so special. Even those Yadava, Krishna's family, they understand Vaikuntha's ecstasy. Even they also worship Vrindavan's residents.
So we shouldn't think that people of Vrindavan are just simply village people with no education, that they're ignorant, they're uneducated. No, people of Vrindavan are not ignorant and they don't suffer.And they don't waste their time.
不是的，文达文的居民呢，不是处在愚昧当中，他们也没有在受苦，他们不会浪费片刻时间。
But the way they act, their behavior, is because of their pure love for Krishna that they act in that way.
他们的行为举止。只是出于对 Krishna 的纯粹的爱，他们才表现出这种行为。
And that's why all the Vaishnavas in Dwarka, including Uddhava, they all worship the people of Vrindavan.
正是由于这个原因 ，Dwarka 的所有的 Vaishnava， 包括 Uddhava 在内，都崇拜 Vrindavan 的居民。
The people of Vrindavan are not bewildered by Krishna.Krishna is bewildered by them.
Vrindavan 的所有居民，他们不是被 Krishna 所困惑，相反 ，Krishna 被 Vrindavan 的居民所困惑。
And some Narada Muni says sometimes Krishna is supposed to do something for the demigods, And I have, Narada said, I had to go and tell him myself, I had to go and remind him.
Narada 说，有的时候呢，Krishna 应该为半神做事情了，我必须得亲自去来提醒他。
And it happened in Vrindavan. Krishna had killed the demon, the Kesi demon, the horse demon, proud Kesi. Krishna killed the Kesi demon. And Krishna was just relaxing with all his friends in Vrindavan. And Narada Muni had to go there and tell him that now it's time for you to leave and go to Mathura. Narada Muni told him, you have to go to Mathura, you have to kill Kamsa. There's different enemies of the devotees there. You have to deal with them.
Narada 告诉 Krishna, 你要去 Mathura 杀掉 Kamsa, 杀掉 Kamsa, 你必须得对付这些敌人。
Because Krishna had promised Brahma before he even came here to this world, Krishna had promised Brahma and the demigods that he would get rid of all these demons from the planet. And so Narada Muni, he had to come and remind Krishna, you know, you have to do this, you have to go there, you have to go to Mathura, you have to fight these demons, you have to kill them.
Narada Muni 就前来提醒 Krishna, 你必须得做这件事，你必须得去 Mathura, 你必须得去杀掉恶魔。
But Krishna just wanted to be with the gopis and with the cowherd boys and the cows. He was enjoying playing the flute, being a cowherd boy. He was so happy there. So it was thanks to Akrura. Akrura came there to Vrindavan and he brought Krishna from Vrindavan to Mathura. Almost by force, he got Krishna to come to Mathura.
So it was thanks to Akrura came to Vrindavan and Krishna from Vrindavan to Mathura.
Krishna wasn't so eager to leave Vrindavan, but Akrura told him about the suffering. He said, your parents, Vasudeva and Devaki, they're suffering there in Mathura. They're in the prison house of Kamsa. You have to come and save them.
Krishna 不想离开 Vrindavan, 但是 Akrura 告诉 Krishna, 你的父亲母亲在 Mathura 在那里受苦。他们被康萨囚禁在监狱里，你必须得去把他们救出来。
Yeah, they're in the prison because of you. They're suffering because of you. So it's your duty. You're their son. You have to go there and save them.
由于你的原因，他们被关在监狱里，他们在那里受苦。你是他们的儿子，你的职责就是去救，把他们从监狱里救出来。
Of course, Krishna can never give up the people of Vrindavan. And even if he leaves, he will come back and he will enjoy his pastimes. So, even again and again, many times, he may leave Vrindavan to go to Mathura to help the Yadus, but again, he will come back to Vrindavan.
So Krishna 呢离开了 Vrindavan, 他又再次返回，他就这样反反复复的，即便他去亚杜家族那里帮助他们，他又会返回来。
And when he comes back to Vrindavan, then again he will enjoy his pastimes with all his devotees.
每次他回到 Vrindavan, 他又会再次和所有这些奉献者一起享受逍遥时光。
But Krishna is also, he wants to see the devotees in Vrindavan. He wants to see how they react in separation from him.
Krishna 也想看文达文的奉献者的反应，他们在分离当中的这种反应。
Yeah, when he sees their separation from him, the pain which they go through in separation from him, then this gives pleasure to Krishna.
Krishna 看到文达文的居民跟他处在跟他的分离之苦当中的时候，这给他带来了快乐。Actually,
sometimes Krishna will play games. Sometimes he will hide in a cave. And he'll say, and he'll watch the gopis or the cowherd boys looking for him. Where's Krishna? And they become worried in separation from him.
Krishna呢会跟他的文达文的这些人玩游戏，他有时候呢躲在山洞里，他从牧牛姑娘、牧牛童的眼前消失。每当这时候呢，他们就会为他担心，处在分离当中。
And then he will reappear. And so Krishna does these pastimes. This is for his pleasure and also for the pleasure of his devotees.
然后之后呢, Krishna 又会再次出现在他们面前。所以这既是为了他自己的快乐，也是为了他的奉献者的快乐。
So this way in which Krishna acts, This is the behavior of a very generous, very charitable person.
这是一个非常慷慨大度的，有着不失心的人的他的行为。
Because he's giving them something which is very, very special, which is very rare.
他给予他们的是非常特殊的，非常罕见的。So
nobody should, we shouldn't criticize Krishna, that Krishna is not fair, he's cruel to the devotees, that he does like this with them.
没有人应该批评 Krishna, Krishna 不公平, Krishna 太残忍了，他这样做了这些事。So
Narada says, he doesn't see any fault in Krishna, although other people may say. But Narada said, there's no fault in Krishna's behavior. It's all to increase the love of the devotees for Krishna.
Narada Muni 就说，他在 Krishna 的行为举止当中看不到任何错误，这一切都是为了增加奉献者对他的爱。
When Krishna is separate from them, then the people of Vrindavan, they can feel that love of Krishna in separation, what is called vipra lamba. The love of Krishna in the separation, this is only felt by the people of Vrindavan.
在分离当中去爱 Krishna, 这只是被文达文的居民呢他们独特的感受。
So Uddhava was appreciating the special love which the gopis had for Krishna, that they felt so much attachment for Krishna in separation.
Uddhava 是非常的欣赏 gopi们对 Krishna的爱，他们如何是在分离当中处在深深的对 Krishna的依恋。And
Uddhava glorifies the gopis. He said that you've by showing this love for Krishna in separation, just allowing me to see it, you've given me the greatest mercy.
Uddhava 就荣耀了牧牛姑娘，只是向我展示你们在分离当中对 Krishna 的爱 只是由于看到这一幕，你们就已经给予我仁慈了。
Because the gopis, they conquered, they, Krishna loved them. They had conquered Krishna by their love for him. So Krishna cannot leave them.
因为 gopis 们他们征服了 Krishna, 他们通过使得Krishna 爱他们，征服了 Krishna, Krishna 不可能离开他们。
So even when gopis are face to face with Krishna, sometimes they feel separation from him just by the blinking of their eyes.
有时候呢，即便 gopi 们跟 Krishna 是面对面待在一起的时候，他们也会感觉到跟 Krishna 的分离，只是由于眨眼睛，他们就感到跟 Krishna 有分离之情了。
So this was.The intensity of their love for Krishna.
这便是他们对 Krishna 的爱的强烈程度。
So Narada Muni says that actually there's no difference between Goloka and Gokula.
Narada Muni 说，实际上 Gokula.
Just like he does these pastimes here on this planet Earth in Vrindavan, he does the same thing in Goloka. Narada Muni wants to encourage Gop Kumar to understand about.The nature of Goloka, the topmost planet in the spiritual world.
Narada Muni 就希望让 Gopa 鼓励 Gopa Kumar 去明白灵性世界最崇高的星球 Goloka 的本性。
Narada Muni said Goloka on Earth is also.The original Goloka. Gokula. Gokula on earth is also Goloka.
Narada Muni 说在地球上的 Gokula 就是最原初的 Goloka.
Although Gokula is in the material world, material universe, and Goloka is above Vaikuntha, there's no real difference between them.
虽然狗哭了处在物质宇宙，但而狗卢卡是外昆塔最高的星球，但他们之间没有什么真正的区别。
Okay, so we will stop here.
那我们讲课部分就到这里。
We'll ask if there's any questions.
我们来接下来来回答问题。第一个问题是喜宝 ，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru 和老师们，请问 Guru， 为什么我现在很努力学习 Krishna 之觉，梦中还是会见到那么多死去的亲人呢？甚至昨晚还梦见健在的母亲和我都死了。也看到低等星球很多鬼魂为了得到一个身体的争斗，请问咕噜应该以什么样的心态来看待这些梦境呢？是不是应该为死去的亲人们做点什么呢？如果我不小心失去生命掉进了低等星球，请问咕噜会来拯救我吗？So, Hare Krishna, business guru and teachers, I would like to ask Guru, although I'm endeavoring to learn Krishna consciousness, but yet still I will see a lot of relatives who passed away in my dream. Even yesterday, I dreamed of my mother and I. My mother is still living. I dreamed she and me.And I have all died. And I also saw in the lower planets that many ghosts are fighting for, for getting a body, material body. My question is that, Guru, in what kind of mentality should I regard those dreams? Should I do something for the past relatives? If I lost my life, and I go to the lower planets, so Guru, can you come and save me?
Hare Krishna. Well, you have been practicing Krishna consciousness only for a short time, but you had a long time association with your mother and with your family and relatives. And you studied also Buddhism for a long time. So it takes some time to remove these things.
您学习Krishna知觉的时间不长，但是您和自己的母亲、家人、亲戚，已经在一起生活很长时间了，而且您接触佛法时间也不短，所以呢，要清除这些呢，是需要花一段时间的。
Yeah, but you don't have to do anything special about these dreams. This is just some dream. They don't have any real meaning. You just continue to practice Krishna consciousness, and gradually your dreams will improve.
您不需要为这些梦采取什么特殊的举动，这些梦也没有真实的意义，您只需要继续修习 Krishna 这些，逐渐的呢，这些梦境呢，这些梦，他们也会。
It will be very good for you to read about Krishna's pastimes before you go to sleep every night.
如果您在每天晚上睡觉之前读阅读朗读Krishna消时光，对你非常有好处。
If you can get the book called Krishna, the Personality of Godhead, and read all the pastimes of Krishna, and this way, then, when you go to sleep at night, you can dream about Krishna.
有一本书叫做《Krishna，至尊性格神手》，Krishna快乐的泉源。这里头有关，是有关Krishna所有的消时光。如果您在睡之前能够阅读这本书，你晚上做梦的时候就能梦见 Krishna。
So, dreams and these relationships with the family and everything, they're all very temporary. They're not eternal. You have to develop your spiritual consciousness. Remember, you're not the body, you're the soul.
这些梦境，而且和自己的家人、亲戚之间的关系是短暂的。 不是永恒的，您需要发展灵性的知觉，您需要记住，您不是这个身体，您是灵魂。So
you can help your mother also by becoming a nice devotee and continuing in Krishna consciousness, regularly chanting and reading the books about Krishna. And in this way, start to think more about Krishna's pastimes instead of about ghosts and things.
您通过自己成为一个优秀的奉献者，就能帮助您的母亲，通过有规律继续修习Krishna知觉，有规律的念诵，规律的阅读有关Krishna。下一个问题来自淡然一笑。去年的时候，思念Krishna还挺甜蜜，还挺幸福，今年怎么这么苦涩呢？ Last year when I missed Krishna, I felt so sweet, so happy. But yet this year I felt so bitter, a bitterness.
When she what? When she
because yesterday, whenever she remembered Krishna, she felt very sweet and happy, a sense of happiness. But this year, when she, she doesn't say this year. If she is related to Krishna, but this year she felt a lot of bitterness in the heart.
Well, I think it's more your mind than the heart. You have to control your mind. There's the bitterness is not in Krishna. The bitterness is due to your own heart, due to your contact with the material energy.
故事说，我认为这个苦涩呢是在你的心意里的苦涩，你应该控制您的心意。这种苦涩呢是跟Krishna没有关系的，这是出自于心意，出自于跟物质能量的接触。Our
experiences in the material world are bitter, but in Krishna consciousness, there's no bitterness.
我们在物质世界的体验是苦涩的，但是在Krishna直觉当中，没有苦涩。You're
saying you taste bitterness, that means you're not tasting Krishna consciousness. You're not in contact with Krishna.
您说呢，您感觉到苦涩，这就意味着您没有处在Krishna知觉当中，您没有跟Krishna接触上。Because
the nature of the spiritual energy is full of bliss.
因为灵性能量的本性是充满着喜乐的。So
we encourage you, don't be put off by this bitterness. Understand that this is just simply due to the mind and due to past in contact with the material energy. But if you continue to chant the holy name, and if you continue to hear about Krishna, you will awaken real bliss, real happiness.
我们鼓励您，就是不要被这种苦涩，因为这种苦涩感到失望，这都是心意的作用，都是由于跟物质能量的接触导致的。您只需要继续念诵 Hare Krishna， 聆听 Krishna， 就能唤醒真正的快乐，真正的喜乐。
No one else tastes bitterness in chanting the holy name or in Krishna consciousness, but we taste the bitterness when we're not doing these things.
别人念诵 Hare Krishna， 别人在 Krishna 知觉当中的时候都没有感觉到苦涩，但是我们感觉到了苦涩，说明我们并没有在做这些事情。
You say you're tasting bitterness, so maybe Krishna's just telling you that if you go back to the material world, then that's what's there for you, bitterness. You go, if you give up Krishna consciousness and go back into the material world, then you will taste bitterness, only bitterness.
您说您品尝到了苦涩，如果您放弃了Krishna知觉，回到了物质世界，那物质世界就只有苦涩。Okay,
其他的问题。下一个是来自一个，这个叫什么？一长串的，这是
anonymous， 这个奉献者，一个YY的，一个没有是不署名的，叫顶白咕噜和翻译顶白您，人是不是不需要自信，只需要谦卑呢 ？I guess this is a new people, new person, obeisance to guru. Is that we we do not need confidence. We only need humbleness.
No, you also need confidence.
不是的，也需要自信。
Of course, humility is also good, but you also need confidence. You have to have faith and confidence in what you're doing.
当然，谦卑也是好的，但是您是需要自信，也是需要信心的。
All of the good qualities will develop by the practice of Bhakti Yoga.
通过修习 Bhakti Yoga, 奉爱瑜伽，所有优秀品质都能发展起来。
By contact with Krishna, when we are connected to Krishna, then we will naturally awaken also the good qualities of Krishna.
通过接触 Krishna,通过跟 Krishna 有联系，我们就会唤醒，好，所有那些好的品质，就是在 Krishna 身上拥有的所有这些好品质，我们也能唤醒。
Just like you put a metal rod into the fire takes on the qualities. The metal bar will take on the qualities of the fire if it's left in the fire.
就像如果把一根铁棒就伸进这个火里头，那么这根金属棒它会就在火里头待一段时间，它就会拥有火的这种品质。
So the same way, if we are in contact with Krishna, we will also develop the good qualities.
同样的，如果我们接触 Krishna, 就会发展起所有的这些好的品质了。
So we have to connect to Krishna by chanting his name and reading books about Krishna and eating food offered to Krishna.
所以我们要跟 Krishna 保持接触，唱诵他的圣名，阅读他的书籍，然后荣耀就是供奉给 Krishna 的寄语。
So, more question.
下一个是 Draupadi Devadasi, 顶拜 Guru Dev, 勾品们因为爱 Krishna 陷入痛苦。我觉得我和奉献者因为没有爱而陷入痛苦。为了照顾好 Rani 宝宝，我和 Chatura 妈妈总是争吵。她觉得无论怎样照顾好孩子，他觉得无论怎样照顾好孩子就是履行职责，是对 Krishna 的爱。而我在想不违背原则的前提下，依靠 Krishna 的仁慈，照顾好孩子就是努力取悦主的表现。但又觉得这样的冲突伤害了我们彼此，哪里出了问题呢？ Obeisance Gurudev, the gopis.They felt distressed because their love for Krishna. Yet, I and devotee are also in distress because we do not have love. In order to take good care of my baby Rani, I always quarrel with Chatura Mataji. She felt, no matter in which way,If we take good care of the child, we are carrying our duty. That's to carry out our duty. That's love for Krishna. Yet, I am thinking that under the condition of not disobeying principle.We depend on the mercy of the Lord. We take good care of the child. That is the symptom of endeavoring to please the Lord. But I felt this conflict has hurt us both. So where is the problem lies? Where is the problem? Why we there are conflict and quarrel?
Because it's Kali Yuga, and you let Kali Yuga come into your midst, and you quarrel.
问题就出现了，这是卡里年代，你们允许卡里进入你们当中，所以呢，就争吵了。
You're thinking you're the mother of the child, you know, and Chatura's thinking, I'm.Your mother-in-law, and I know I had a child of my own before, and I know about children, I know more than you, I'm experienced. And you're thinking, you're educated, you know more than her, and this way you're arguing.
你在想啊，我是孩子的妈妈，而 Chatura 呢，她是婆婆。Chatura 呢，她就想，我以前都生过孩子，所以我有经验。知道怎么养孩子，您在觉得啊，我受过教育，我知道的更多，所以呢，就是你们之间有争吵。
Because you're both conditioned souls, so you still have this nature to argue with each other.
因为你们都是受条件限制的灵魂，所以有这种彼此争吵的本性。
So what is the solution? The solution is you both have to try to advance in Krishna consciousness.
那么怎么解决呢？解决方案就是你们都要在 Krishna 知觉当中取得进步。
Will take some time.
取得进步啊，需要时间。
You have to do better chanting.You also have to satisfy Chatura Mataji. Chatura Mataji is naturally concerned for the health of your child. So you have to satisfy her.
所以您呢，还是要更好的念诵，提高念诵。同时呢，您需要取悦 Chatura Mataji。因为呢 ,Chatura 他是自然而然的对孩子怀着爱的，所以您也需要满足他。
You have to make sure you're eating healthy. That you want to breastfeed your child, but you have to make sure your milk is good. That you yourself are in good health. You have to eat good food. You have to make sure you have enough milk to feed your baby, and it should be good quality milk. The milk from your breast should be good, should be satisfying for the child. So you have to make sure that you eat good, so that your body can produce good milk for your child.
你要确保您吃的食物是健康的，因为您在给孩子哺乳，所以呢。您要保持，就是您的食物呢，您必须吃好高质量的食物，以便给孩子提供充足的奶水，还有高质量的奶水来满足孩子的生长需要。所以您得确保自己的身体也是非常好的，吃的很好。
Because the doctor looked at the child, doctor said child's not getting enough nourishment.Lacking some basic nutrition in the body, not very good. So that means your milk is not very good. So you have to make sure you have a good health. You have to eat better.
这就意味着这个孩子的他，身体当中就没有得到这个生长发育充足的养分营养。这说明了您的奶水的质量不好，您需要让自己更健康，让自己能吃得更好，食物更，就是更好的食物吧。
I know in India, the ladies there, here in India, they take a lot, they take the ludo tang, you know, green bean soup.
Mm.
It's very nutritious. And of course, in China, you see, you don't get you cannot just buy fresh milk so easily.
买那个鲜牛奶不那么容易。
That's the best thing. If she can drink fresh milk. Also, you want to have wheat. If you can get wheat, fresh wheat, then you can make some chapati bread. It's very nourishing.
有名的 baby 是一定能说这个。
No, the mother. The mother.
Oh. 您能喝到新鲜的牛奶，这对您是很有好处的。还有，如果您能有这种，就是质量很好的麦，就是麦，面粉，新鲜的面粉，就可以做这个 chapati，这 chapati 也是很好的。
Eat chapati and dal. That's very nutritious.
就这个chapati薄饼，还有豆汤，这个都是很有营养的。
Then you can have nice milk to feed your baby from your breast.
这样呢，您就能给您的宝宝提供，就是有营养的奶，母乳。
And when your baby is healthy and happy, then Chatura will be happy.
当您的宝宝既健康又快乐的时候，查图勒也会快乐了。OK，下一个问题。 下一个是 Radha Priya Devadasi， 顶拜古鲁的莲花组。感谢主持人的甜美福。您刚才讲到牧牛姑娘眨眼之间都会感到跟 Krishna 的分离。 我们目前是眨眼之间想起这事儿怎么办？那人的好坏，就是不能专心想着 Krishna， 如何达到牧牛姑娘那样对 Krishna 的爱呢？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. Just now we mentioned that when the gopis they blink their eyes, they will feel the separation with Krishna. But for us, we blink our eyes, we'll think of these things and that things, and this person is good and bad, and we cannot concentrate on thinking about Krishna. So how can we attain the love of the gopi, we attain the level of gopi's love for Krishna?
Yeah. Yes, we have a long way to go to get the gopis' love of Krishna.
是的，要得到像牧牛姑娘对 Krishna 那样的爱，我们还有漫长的路要走。
Anyway, we're hearing about the gopis and we're beginning to understand about their love for Krishna. So this is the start. We hear about the gopis and we will start to also think more about the gopis and how they love Krishna.
无论如何，我们已经开始了我们的漫漫征程了。我们聆听到gopi们他们是如何的爱 Krishna，我们明白到Krishna和gopi之间的这种爱的关系。
We hear about the gopis, how they're always talking about Krishna and remembering Krishna's pastimes, so then we will also start to think more about Krishna and to remember Krishna's pastimes.
我们听到，gopi们是如何相互谈论 Krishna， 想着 Krishna 逍遥时光。 同样的谈论 Krishna， 想着 Krishna 的消时光。
When we do kirtan, this is how we cultivate the mood of the gopis.
我们做我 kirtan 就是在培养牧牛姑娘的心态。
And we should always be thinking, where is Krishna? When is Krishna coming? When will I see Krishna?
我们还应该想着 ，Krishna 在哪里 ？Krishna 什么时候来？我什么时候才能看见 Krishna？
But if we sit and watch television, if we sit and look at television in the evenings, then it won't help us to remember Krishna.
可是如果我们晚上坐在那里盯着电视机看，就不会帮助我们想起 Krishna。
So we want to develop the mood of the gopis. We have to follow the mood of the gopis and we have to become very, very attached to Krishna and speaking and remembering Krishna.
如果我们希望发展起 gopi 的心态，我们必须要追随 Gopi 的步伐，非常非常的依附 Krishna， 想着 Krishna， 谈论 Krishna。
Maybe you have to go and live in the village and take care of the cows.
也许你应该去乡下住，然后去那里照料母牛。
Be like a Gopi.
就像 Gopi 那样。
But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all his devotees, they follow in the mood of the gopis.
但是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 和他的同游都是追随牧牛姑娘的。
They all take the mood of the gopis and they do a lot of kirtan, chanting of the holy name. Kirtan is very powerful to develop the mood of the gopis.
他们就是做很多的 kirtan， 唱诵圣名，所以 kirtan 是非常有助于发展 gopi 的心绪的。
If you can do more kirtan, then you'll start to appreciate more. This is the mood. But when we do kirtan, we're thinking Krishna is there in the holy name. Krishna has come in the form of the holy name.
所以需要做更多的 kirtan， 祈诵圣名，唱诵圣名，这样我们就能够更加欣赏。但是当我们做 kirtan 的时候，我们应该想着 Krishna 就在哪里， Krishna 就在圣名当中， Krishna 以圣名的形式到来了，降临了。
So this is how the gopis would pacify themselves when they're in separation from Krishna. They would do kirtanIn this way, they would feel Krishna's presence.
当 Krishna 从他们眼前消失的时候，牧牛姑娘们他们就是通过 kirtan 来安慰他们自己，他们感觉这样 Krishna 就在他们中间。
All right. 还有问题吗？
还有。下面是来自于，对不起，我不知道这个名字是玉吗？玉静，如果念错了，请包涵。素食文化，顶拜孤儿莲花族，感谢翻译主持的甜美服务。我是一名刚学习 Krishna 知觉的学生，我没有正规的系统学习，平常就是听朋友讲解，学习博伽梵歌。我想问问，为什么每次我在听博伽梵歌的时候总是犯困，并且能睡得很香？其实我平时睡眠不好，我时常想，难道博伽梵歌能催眠吗？我想了解为什么有这种现象。Just contact with Krishna consciousness has not system, undergone a systematic study. Usually she would hear friends explain Bhagavad Gita. And her question is why each time I listen to Bhagavad Gita, I felt so sleepy and I slept very soundly. Yet my quality of sleep is not good usually. So I wonder that Bhagavad Gita has that effect of hypnotism. So I would like to know why I have this symptom.
Yes, it's not uncommon for people when in the beginning, but when they hear Bhagavad Gita or when they hear the scriptures, that somehow their mind becomes calm and they fall asleep.
Mm, 新人他们接触到菩萨梵歌，接触到经典的时候，他们的心意就变得非常非常的平静。Anyway,
the real purpose of hearing the scriptures is not just to sleep. You have to get over that. You have to go beyond this.
但无论如何，聆听经典的目的不是为了睡觉。
But ideally, when you come to hear the scriptures, you should have had a good rest, and then you won't fall asleep when you hear.
理想的状态，状况就是当你聆听经典《佛教梵歌》之前，你应该在聆听之前就是已经睡得很好了，已经有一个很好的睡眠。
Now, if you haven't had a good sleep and still you come to hear the Bhagavad Gita, then maybe you better stand up so that you don't fall asleep.
但是如果您在来听课之前没有休息好，睡得很好，那么在您听《佛教梵歌》的时候，您最好站起来，不要昏昏欲睡。
Right, you sit down and then you sit down and you gradually your head goes down and you bend your back and then you go to sleep.
但是如果您是采取坐姿的话，那渐渐的您的头也越来越低，然后您的背也弯下来了，然后最后您就睡着了。 So
you want to hear with care and attention. So it's very important that you try to conquer over this inattention.
所以您需要，就是小心翼翼的，专注的来聆听，因此要征服这种就是不专注的聆听的现象。So
we say, you know, first thing is you try to get a good night's sleep, first of all. You have difficulty sleeping, then do more chanting. And when you chant nicely, you do a lot of chanting, then you'll be able to sleep better.
就是，您需要有一个很好的睡眠。如果您是有这种失眠的现象的话，那就是很难入睡。您就可以起来念诵，然后您有很好的、很有质量的念诵，然后这样呢，您的睡眠质量也会提高的。Yes,
and if you, okay. I slipped my mind now what I was going to tell you. Okay. So Hearing is a very important part of the process of bhakti yoga. If you don't hear carefully, then how are you going to learn about Krishna consciousness?
如果您不聆听，怎能学习Krishna知觉呢？
So we encourage you, you know, please better try to stay awake when we have classes. And one thing is, don't sleep during the day. If you sleep during the day, then it will be difficult for you to get a good sleep at night.
我们鼓励您，就是不要在那个聆听，聆听不加放歌的时候，睡着。我们鼓励您，就是白天有一个办法，就是白天你不要睡觉，这样呢，如果你白天不睡觉，你晚上的时候就能很好的入睡了。公说鼓励您那个不要在聆听不加放歌的时候睡着，要保持清醒。
Some people take notes when they're hearing classes. They like to take notes. Maybe that would help to keep you awake.
有些人有这个习惯，就是听课的时候，他们习惯于记笔记，所以记笔记的习惯呢，就会帮助您保持清醒。
But sleeping is a type of ignorance.
睡眠是愚昧，一种愚昧的形式。
We cannot hear, especially when transcendental knowledge is being vibrated. You want to hear with care and attention.
当人昏昏欲睡的时候，他就无法正确的聆听了，尤其是当聆听超然知识的时候，是需要就是满怀，小心翼翼的、专注的去聆听超然的知识的。 刚刚讲课中谈到，Narada Muni说Krishna根本不跟他说话。请问Gurudev，Narada Muni这样一位特殊的主的成分奉献者，与主Krishna什么关系？然后Krishna对他的爱通过什么方式表达？Narada Muni总是那么喜乐，弹奏他的Vena琴，喜乐的唱诵主的圣名，好像从来没有痛苦，分离的痛苦。Please Gurudev, just now in the lecture you mentioned that Narada Muni said Krishna does not talk with him. So my questions are, Gurudev, Narada Muni, such a special pure devotee as Narada Muni, what's the relationship between him and Krishna? And in which way Krishna expressed his love to Narada Muni? Narada Muni is so blissful, always playing his vina and chanting Krishna's holy name. It seems that he never felt the pain of separation.
Yes, right. Narada Muni does not feel the pain of separation.
是的，Narada
Muni is a Vaikuntha man. He's not from Goloka.
Narada Muni is a Vaikuntha 居民，他不是来自Goloka的。
This pain of separation is only felt in Goloka by the Brijbasi people.
这种分离之苦，只是Goloka。
Narada Muni he's in a different position. He has a different role to play.
Narada Muni 呢，他是跟他们不一样，他有他的角色。
So, what is Narada Muni's relationship with Krishna? He's a servant of Krishna. And at the same time, yeah, Generally, we think of Narada Muni as the servant because he's from Vaikuntha, and in Vaikuntha, the prominent rasa is servant. The people, nearly all the living entities in Vaikuntha are in servant, dasya ras, with Krishna.
Narada Muni 跟 Krishna 的关系是他是仆人的关系，在Vaikuntha。 那里的那个主导的 rasa 是 dasya rasa， 这是最重要的关系。
So Krishna doesn't speak to Narada Muni when he's enjoying with all the Brijbasi people and when he's with his gopis, and he doesn't bother about Narada Muni. Yeah.
所以 Krishna 在那里忙着和 Brijbasi 跟那些牧牛姑娘在那里享受呢，所以他就
Krishna is having his greatest pleasure with all the Brijbasi people. He doesn't think about Narada Muni. Narada Muni is, he's something else. He's not from Vrindavan.
Narada Muni, Krishna 就感受到 最大的快乐就是和Brijbasi在一起，他感到非常的快乐，所以他并没有花心思放在Narada Muni身边。Narada Muni是从别的地儿来的。But
Narada Muni, Krishna appreciates Narada Muni.
但是呢, Krishna他也是欣赏Narada Muni的。He
knows Narada Muni is always chanting the holy name.
他知道Narada Muni总时刻的唱诵的圣名。
Narada Muni chants the name Narayan, Narayan.
他唱诵的是 Narayana, Narayana.
Okay.
下一个是来自于王文言, Akasha Deva, Devka, Dimaguru. 来翻译和奉献者，我修习 Krishna 之觉半年了，目前饮食清淡，不吃鱼肉蛋，但家里孩子、先生还是要食用这些，每次给他们做，都觉得 Krishna 很伤心，我心情不好，有内疚和急躁，请问怎么平衡这种心态？So this new devotee, she had practiced Krishna consciousness for half a year. She didn't eat meat, fish, egg, but her child and husband will eat those things. So each time she cooked for them, she felt that Krishna is very sad. And she herself also felt guilty and upset. So how she asked how to balance this mentality.
So what you need to do is learn how to cook very nice vegetarian meals, and you attract your family members to eat with you. But you have to learn how to cook very satisfying, tasty, attractive vegetarian dishes.
您需要去学习怎么做出的素食啊，是特别吃完之后让人心满意足的，又是美味的佳肴的，而且让人一看就垂涎欲滴的这种食物素食。If
you can cook some nice foodstuffs and tasty, if they can, you know, just if they see it and they smell it, they can be attracted because it will be so much better than what they're eating just now.
如果他们就是看见您做的这一桌素食的美味佳肴，然后闻到这个色香味俱全的这个素食又这么好吃的，这远远比他们现在吃的这些食物要好得多。So
you introduce gradually one item after another, different things. You cook these vegetarian dishes and let them become attracted and be and like them, and then gradually you can make them also vegetarian.
就您可以一样一样给他们上，就是让他们喜欢上一样素菜，又喜欢另外一样素菜，这样就是不同的素菜，让他们都感到受到这些这个味道的吸引，然后喜欢上吃素，就慢慢的就让他们改变饮食。
At least at home, when you cook for them, they'll be happy to eat your nice vegetarian meals.
至少是在家里头，让他们特别快乐的吃您做给他们做的这种美味的素食。
So it's really up to you. You have to be a good cook. You have to really want to cook nice dishes.And they can be attractive.
这一切都得取决于您自己，您得成为一个非常优秀的厨师，做非常好吃的美味佳肴，让他们感到被这个您做的所吸引，深深吸引。
下一个问题。
下一个来自李林恩，顶麦古尔顶麦翻译。我有一个八个月的小宝宝，每天小宝宝看我做普沙的念诵圣名，下午给宝宝读国家梵歌，每天给宝宝看 Krishna 神像，请教咕噜还有什么更好的建议让宝宝从小爱 Krishna。 This lady, she pay obeisance to you. She had a baby that is 8 months old. Every daySo she cooked prasadam and chant holy name during the daytime, and in the afternoon she would read the Bhagavad Gita for her baby and to show Krishna's deities to her baby. She asked you, are there any better suggestions that can let the baby love Krishna from a very early age?
Yes, you just continue to let the baby hear Hare Krishna Kirtan, chanting of the holy name.
是的，让这个小宝宝听 Hare Krishna Kirtan, 聆听这个 Hare Krishna 的圣名。
And you sing the songs about Krishna. You sing to the baby, and when you're not singing, then you can play recordings of other people singing.Let the baby hear spiritual sound vibrations.
您给这个小宝宝就唱 Krishna 的歌曲，如果您自己不唱的时候，您可以给他播放这个录音，让他听到这个灵性的音振。
And give the baby nice Krishna prasadam.
还要给这个小宝宝吃。好吃的美味的 Krishna 的 prasadam.
Whatever you give the baby to eat, first of all you offer to Krishna.
无论你给小宝宝吃什么，都首先要给 Krishna 供奉。下一个王文言。还是那个奉献者 Akasha Devaka 顶拜 Guru 所有的生物都是 Krishna 的仆人或仆人的仆人，可以这样理解吗？ Business Guru, all the living entities are servant of Krishna or servant of Krishna. Is that understanding all right?
Yes, this is right.
是的，这个理解很好。下一个，最后一个，开心。顶拜咕噜奉献者们，牧牛姑娘们和 Krishna 的分离之苦是超然的。我们在这里和 Krishna 的分离是痛苦的。我从12岁开始，心里就偶尔有一种空空的感觉。总是感觉缺少点什么，直到前年得到国家梵歌，了解了 Krishna 之后，这种感觉就消失了。请问 Guru， 这是因为我们忘记了 以 Krishna 的关系导致的吗？ Hare Krishna。 So this devotee is called happiness. She paid obeisance to you and all devotees, and she said that the gopis separation with Krishna is transcendental, yet our separation with Krishna here is painful. So from 12 years old, she felt some the feeling of vacantness, voidness in vacant in her heart. She felt there's also something lacking. Until the year before last year, she got a Bhagavad Gita and she know about Krishna. So that feeling vanished. She would ask you, so is that due to our forgetfulness of our relationship with Krishna?
Yes.
是的。
As soon as you forget Krishna, then you'll feel the material energy. And the material energy gives some pleasure, but very short pleasure. And quickly that pleasure becomes pain.
就是一旦我们忘记了 Krishna, 我们立刻就会被物质能量所掌控着。当我们和物质能量接触的时候，有些许的快乐，但很快这种快乐就会转化成，这种快乐是短暂的，而且很快这种快乐就会转变成痛苦。
Yeah, material world is not going to give us any real shelter, but there's the illusion that we have shelter here.
物质世界不能提供我们真正的庇护，就是我们感觉，我们在物质世界里有庇护，这是出于幻象。
Have I answered the question?
Yes.
Okay.
Still, that's a devotee who asked a previous question, Akasha Deep.Ask, 请问 Guru, 在尽力学习做美味的素食，但该怎么面对目前的状态？我是坚决不给他们做肉，还是慢慢过渡呢？没有 Guru 的回答，我真的很焦虑。She asked, so, I would try to learn how to do delicious vegetarian meal.But how can I face my present situation? Should I be very determined not to cook meat for them, or should I gradually stop to cook for them? So she felt very worried without your answer.
Well, it's difficult for me to give you that answer because I don't know enough about your family situation. I don't want your husband to divorce you.I don't want your family to kick you out of the house. I don't know exactly, you know, your family relationship.
Guru 说他很难给你一个明确的就是答案，因为他不了解您的目前的状况。他不希望，Guru 说不希望您的跟您的丈夫离婚，然后你的家人把你从家庭当中赶出去，因为他不了解您的真正的，就是您现在目前的家庭关系是什么样子的。
So I suggested that it's better you maybe do it gradually, because I know you probably don't know much about cooking, and it will take you some time to learn.
所以姑建议您逐渐的过渡，因为您现在呢还不是很擅长做饭，所以学习呢也是需要时间。
But you gradually introduce to them more and more nice vegetarian preparations.
您逐渐的就给他们介绍，让他们 把这些好吃的素食给他们引进到你的家庭的餐桌上。
And gradually you can tell them that I'm just going to cook vegetarian and if I will cook these nice meals for you every day, but if you want to eat meat, then I'm sorry, I don't want to cook.
然后呢，之后呢，您就可以告诉他们，我现在啊，我只能给你们做素食，天天给你们做这些好吃的素食。如果你们想吃肉的话，那对不起，我不想给你们再做了。
So gradually, I think it would be better for you to do it gradually.
所以要逐渐的来，我认为就是逐渐渐渐的过程呢，就更是比较好的。
Okay.
慢慢的过渡，慢慢的过渡。还有一个是 fairy 和 fairy。最后一个顶拜咕噜，请问目前我说服务咕噜和 Krishna 还带有自私享受的欲望，请问如何净化这样受污染的心意呢？而且当我感到孤独痛苦，我会把 Krishna 当成我的同伴来冥想，这是一种冒犯吗？是This called, new people is called a fairy, a business guru. For the present moment, when I say serve guru and Krishna, there is a tinge of sense gratification, selfish desire of enjoyment. I ask guru, how can I purify this contaminated mind?Each time when I feel painful and lonely, I would meditate Krishna as my companion. Is this a kind of offense?
No, there's no offense. Meditating on Krishna as your companion, that's all right. Think of Krishna as your friend. That's nice, because you're thinking of Krishna. So it's good.We're encouraged to think of Krishna. But the best way to think of Krishna is by chanting his name.
不是冒犯，想着 Krishna 是自己的朋友，这是非常好的，因为这是在想着 Krishna， 所以我们鼓励您想着 Krishna。但是最好的想着 Krishna 的方法是唱诵他的名字。
Yeah.There are different friends of Krishna. Arjuna is a friend, and cowherd boys are also friends. Uddhava is also a friend.
朋友有不同种类的朋友。Arjuna 是 Krishna 的一类朋友，牧牛童是 Krishna 的一类朋友， Uddhava 也是 Krishna 的一类朋友。
In order to become the real friend of Krishna, first you have to become a good servant.
要成为 Krishna 的真正朋友，首先呢，要做 Krishna 的仆人。
Anyway, you're a new devotee, so you keep thinking of Krishna. And remember, we're not equal to Krishna. We're a servant of Krishna.
无论如何，您是新人，您能想着 Krishna， 但是呢，不要想着您和 Krishna 是平起平坐，要想着您是 Krishna 的仆人。
So being Krishna's friend is also a service to Krishna, pleasing to Krishna.
做 Krishna 的朋友也是对 Krishna 的一种服务。是能够取悦 Krishna 的。
And sometimes you think of the first part of the question, you think of Krishna or the Guru, is it?
The first part is that whenever I said that I talk about service to Guru and Krishna, there is some
selfish.
Tinge of selfish enjoyment.
Well, that's good. If you get enjoyment by serving Guru and Krishna, that's not wrong. You should find pleasure in service to Guru and Krishna.
这是好的，就是服务 Guru Krishna， 您能给您带来快乐，您应该想服务 Krishna， 服务 Guru。
But we should always feel that our service is not perfect, that we want to serve better.
但是我们应该总是想着我们应该觉得我们的服务不完美，我们应该提升、改进我们的服务。
All right. All right. No more questions.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol.
Hare Bol. Good day. 就是 Ferry 的他的这个问题，就是说，他说在这个服务 Guru 和 Krishna 的时候，总是有这种就是自己享受的这样的欲望。这种心态是好的吗？
No.Yes, it's good. Yeah, it's good. It's not wrong. Shangshou, we want to enjoy. Yeah, we all want to enjoy. So if we get enjoyment by serving Guru and Krishna, very good. That's right. We enjoy by service.
我们通过服务去享受。
Very good.
很好。
Nothing wrong.
没有错的，没有错。
You should be greedy for more service.
应该，贪婪着要更多的服务。So whenever she felt, as soon as the service of Guru and Krishna is concerned, she felt that she still had some desire, selfish desire for enjoyment. That's the first part of the question. So she asked how to purify this polluted mind.
By doing more service.Do more service for Guru and Krishna, and that will purify the polluted heart.
为 Guru Krishna 做更多服务，就能净化这个被污染的心意了。
Yes. Alright.
好的。Good day. 我们已经到时间了，但是现在还有一位新人发了一个问题，您还有时间吗？
可以。
这一位新人叫蓝妹子，顶拜咕噜，心态一直处在灵性状态中，为什么会出现眼前的一切都如同行走的幽灵 ？So basis guru, although the mind, the mentality is always situated in the spiritual condition. So why that everything appeared in my, so everything that in front of me, I see everything that is like a ghost, subtle spirit that walking in front of me.So she said, although she felt that she's also always situated in this, her mentality is always situated in the spiritual, level. So why she felt she saw everything in front of her eyes? It's like a walking subtle spirit.
I don't know why. This very unusual. I don't know what's wrong with her, why she sees like this. Maybe she's ghostly haunted, I don't know. Maybe some evil spirits are troubling her. Anyway, she can remove all these things by becoming more Krishna conscious, by chanting of the holy name. The loud chanting of the holy name will remove all inauspiciousness.
不知道为什么你会看到这种景象，也许呢是被鬼魂附体了，也许有些邪灵在给你带来麻烦，所以你需要把这个不吉祥的因素要去除掉，要变得更有Krishna知觉，唱诵圣就是高声的唱诵圣名，大声的唱诵圣名，可以去除所有不吉祥。
And be very careful to keep yourself very pure and clean.
要特别的小心，让你自己保持，让你自己的生活，让你自己保持一种纯洁、干净的状态。
Stay away from all kinds of intoxication, alcohol, and meat, and these other contaminated things.
不要沾麻醉品，不要沾酒，不要沾肉食，沾这些被污染的食物。Okay. 啊，还有一个。这位是来自 Rasa， 孩子10岁。 如何避免他对于在外面受到的肉食的诱惑？因为他也要交朋友，无论大人孩子都诱惑他吃肉，在学校一样顶白咕噜。So this mother called Rasa. Her daughter is 10 years old. So she asked how to avoid the daughter to be attracted by the meals outside, because the daughter also has to make friends with others, and no matter the adults and children all attract her to eat meat, even in the school. So she paid obeisance to you.
Well, you simply have to prepare you have to have very nice vegetarian food, that she's so happy and satisfied eating your nice vegetarian dishes that she's not attracted to eat meat.
你只要去做美味的素食，就是让你的女儿吃了以后感到心满意足，感到就是特别高兴，就她就不会受外面的这些
And you should can also encourage your daughter to have a love for animals and explain that this meat, that these are animals which have been killed cruelly.
吃的肉呢，都是这些动物被残忍的杀戮得来的肉食。And
explain to her also the health advantages of being vegetarian.
给你女儿解释，做一个素食者，对健康带来的好处。More
and more people in China are becoming vegetarian.
现在呢，在全中国，素食的人口是越来越庞大。
So, you should encourage your daughter. don't be tricked by these meat eaters.
您需要鼓励您的女儿不要被那些肉食者玩弄了，不要上他们当。
Vegetarian means healthy, wealthy, and wise.
素食就意味着健康，有财富，并且是睿智的、聪明的。
There's nothing to be gained by being a meat eater.
做肉食者呢是没有得不到什么好处的。
I think the people who want to be her friend, they should respect her for being a vegetarian.Not that she has to eat meat to be friends with them, but they should appreciate her that she's a vegetarian.
姑姑说，她认为呢，那想跟你女儿交朋友的人应该尊敬你的女儿，做一个尊敬你的女儿，就是做吃素。他们，你的女儿不应该是为了跟他们交朋友去吃肉。他们呢，他的朋友呢，应该欣赏你的女儿。
Okay.
Okay. 好的，今天的问题就到这里了。
Okay. 我们感谢所有的奉献是聆听，感谢 Guru Mani 给我们讲台的翻译，感谢 Sati 主持。感谢所有的奉献者，祝福你们新年快乐 ，Hare Krishna， 祝福各位 ，Ki，
在
，Go back to Brindaki，
在
，Hare Bol。